Sahana Vavatu Sahano Bhunaktu Sahaviryam Karavavahai Tejasvina Vadhidamastoma Vidvishavahai Om Shanti 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 Om Yogena Jittasya Padena Vacham Malam Sharirasya Chavaidyakena Yopakarottam Pravaram Muninam Padanjalim. Padanjalim Pranjaliranatosmi. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Shri Satguru Maharaj Ki Jai. So a brief comparison of Vedanta and Sankhya Yoga philosophy. So we remember we discussed about the philosophy, six philosophical systems in the introduction itself. Here, I'm going to give some insight on Vedanta, where Vedanta is connected with Sankhya. So when we see all Shankara Bhashyam, the commentary of Sri Shankaracharya, there in many places Shankaracharya quotes Sankhya, Sankhya Karika and Yoga Sutra. So there some places for the debate or some places for some comments or to show something special, something, some point, special points. So we'll just see. So while first we take an important point. Shankaracharya is defining what Sankhya means. Sankhya, what the definition of Sankhya. He says, Sankhyam Nama, it is in 18th chapter of Gita, 13th sloka. The Sankhyam Nama, Ime Sattva Rajastamamsi Gunaha, Maya Drishya, Aham Tebhyo Anyaha, Tad Vyapara Sakshi Bhudo Nityo Guna Vilakshanaha, Atme Veiti, Chintanameva Sankhyo Yogaha Tena Pashyandi Atmana Matmana Iti. You can see the correct definition. He is summarizing all the Sankhya philosophy there. So Sankhya is separating Purusha and Prakriti. So what is Purusha? What is Prakriti? Sattva Rajas Tamamsi Gunaha. So these are the gunas. And these gunas are my object, drishya maya. Tad vyapara sakshi bhudo nityaha. I am the observer of these gunas. Who am I? I am guna vilakshanaha. I am different from gunas. So this thought, this contemplation is called Sankhya Yoga. So he is quoting this. And now, again, Guna-sanghyane. The Guna-sanghyane is also in Bhagavad Gita, 18th chapter, 19th sloka. Guna-sanghyane means Kapile Shastri. This is the Shastram called Kapila Shastra. It means Sankhya Shastra. It is established by Kapila, Kapila Rishi. Then he says, this is comment on that. Is it useful or what? So he says, Tadabi Guna Sankhyanam Shastram. So this Sankhya philosophy is counting the gunas and giving the definition of gunas and the manifestation of gunas. So that is Shastram. And Guna Bhoktri Vishaye Pramanameva. That is the authority for this gunas and its manifestation connected to Jivatma. Guna Bhoktri Vishaye Pramanameva. So we accept this part of Sankhya because otherwise in Gita it is not possible. Other than Sankhya, these three gunas are not there in any other philosophy or in Vedas, you cannot see clearly. Vedas, it is there, but it is not established. If you want to know what is Sattva, Rajas, Tama, Guna, Sankhya Shastram is the only authority, only source, no other way. So even in Gita, it is there, so you have to accept this. Then he quotes there, no? Add their word, Paramartha Vishaya, Paramartha Brahma Ekatva Vishaya Yadyavi Virudhyade. So our contradiction is with the duality. So we are not accepting the duality. Although that is pramanam, that is the authority of guna, that we accept. Okay. But regarding Brahma Ekatva Jnana, it is not. Because they are dualistic. So that is the comment on. There are many, I can quote a little more. Then Yoga Shastra, Yoga Shastrebi Atha Tattva Darshana Upayo Yogaha. This is quoted in Brahma Sutra. It means there was a Yoga Shastra which started with this sutra, Atha Tattva Darshana Upayo Yogaha. But this Yoga Shastra is not available now. It was there, he is quoting from that. The Yoga Shastra, in the yogic test book, it is saying something like this. So that is also useful. That is what he says in the Brahma Sutra, second chapter, first part, third sutra. Then about our Parakaya Sarira also he says, Esha Evacha Yoga Shastreshu Yoginam Anega Sarira Yoga Prakriya. So it means he studied these sutras, yoga sutras. And the quotings, actually he is quoting the sutras also. And there he studied this system of, this methodology of Parasarira Pravesha, making many bodies. You have seen the sutra in the third, fourth chapter. So Yoginam Anega Sarira Prayoga, Nirmana Chittani. So he is talking about that. That is also in Brahma Sutra 4.4.15. And Yoga Shastra Prasiddha Manasaha Panjavrittayaha Parigrihyante. Here he quotes the sutra, Pramanavyare Viparya Vikalpa Nidra Smritayaha. This sutra is quoted in Brahma Sutra. The second chapter, fourth part. Then about Nadi, Sushumna Nadi. Hridayad Urdhvam Pravritta Sushumna Nama Nadi Yoga Shastreshu Cha Prasiddhaha. So about Sushumna Nadi, it is there in Vedas, in Taittiriya Upanishad and Katha Upanishad, Chandogya Upanishad, the Sushumna Nadi is there. So this is famous in yoga also, the Yoga Shastreshu Cha Prasiddha. So similarly, we have you can see the connections now. Now I was quoting this wordings of Shankaracharya from the Gita itself. how the consciousness is reflected in intellect, pure intellect, and why we accept it. It means the intellect become conscious. How it is conscious, how we can practice jnana in that, jnana nishtha. So you want to practice the knowledge and meditate on that. If the mind is not the self, then how can you do that? This is the question. So he answered this like this. Atyanda nirmalatva svachatva sushmatva upapatteir atmano buddhescha atma sama nairmalyadi upapattehe. Atma sama nairmalya. So this intellect, which is transparent now, can be one with atma, one with the self. So that much transparency intellect gets after you practice all these sadhanas. So nirmalatvat, it is without impurities. Swachha, it is pure. And sukshma, it is subtle. So these qualities are there in atma. These qualities are there in consciousness. The same quality this intellect also attained. So now it can be together, like a clear crystal. So where you keep the crystal, crystal takes the color of the object there, the color there. It is one with that. You cannot separate it. So this way, buddhyabhyasam manaha. So we have seen this reflection sequence. You see, he is quoting there. Then first the reflection comes to buddhi, the intellect. Then buddhyabhasam manaha. Then that is reflected in mind. So mind become conscious there. So we have seen the chart, no? When we studied that. And from there, tada abhasani indriyani. When there this consciousness is reflected to senses. Indriya abhasascha deha. Then those senses, this body become conscious, become sentient. So this is also, he is taking the same system also, Sankhya. He is changing the word, that's all. The idea is the same. This method is quoting there in many places. And Brahma Sutra and Upanishads also. And when it comes to 15th chapter of Gita, Adhashagham, Urdhamulam Adhashagham. So there is a tree of this, what is the samsara, vriksha, the tree of creation or the cosmos, whatever we say. So in that, adhashakam, mahat ahankara tanmatradayah shakha. Here he is using this mahat ahankara tanmatra as in the Sankhya system. Then that sequence he is taking it. Because in this context, we cannot bring the Upanishad creation methodology. Because it is not connecting here. This is, you have to follow Sankhya only. So from Prakriti, the Mahat, the second, and Ahankara is the third, then Tanmatra, out of that, so he is taking that, Mahat Ahankara Tanmatra, Tayaha. And then, Purusha, the conjunction of Prakriti and Purusha. Now, how it is? That is, in Vedanta it says, Purushasya, Prakritisthatva rupena mithyajnanena yuktasya bhogyeshu guneshu sugha dukha mohatmakeshu sankaha. This is the attachment of consciousness. That's what it is. Prakritisthatva rupena is there in Prakriti. He is dwelling in Prakriti or Prakritisthatva. He is standing in Prakriti or something. how it is possible? Mithya jnanena yuktasya. Tasya hedur avidya, as sutra says. So because of superimposition, misunderstanding, he is one with that. Now he is attached to the prakriti, attached to this material cause, with the body and elements. Then bhogyeshu gunaha, guneshu. Actually these gunas, the trigunas, they are bhogyas. They are object of enjoyments. But he is one with that. He sees himself as an enjoyer with this. And prakriti sambhavaha is the all creation comes from prakriti. But here the prakriti is under Ishvara. Bhagavad Maya Asrayaha. This is one comparison. That in Sankhya prakriti, the same prakriti is Maya in Vedanta system. So it changed it to Maya. Why it is Maya? Now here the prakriti is completely independent. Prakriti produces itself. Independent entity, independent principle. But in Vedanta we won't want an independent principle. So we connected it to Maya. So it means Maya is under the consciousness. Consciousness is guiding Maya. The Maya is not independent. Maya is power of Brahman. The ultimate energy or in the form of power. It is connected one with Brahman. So that is part of Brahman. So that is there. Then janma karanam cha avidya nimittakaha kshetra kshetratnya samyogaha. So in Kshetra, the 13th chapter of Gita, if you want to know more about Sankhya, you can read that because it is full of Sankhya philosophy. So there, the connection between body and this consciousness, that is also because of ignorance. Because of ignorance, they are separate, but because of ignorance you consider as it one. From that kshetra kshetrajna samyogat, from that all creation starts. Here also drashtra drishyo samyogaha heya hetuho, the samyoga, the conjunction, is the cause of all creation. So the same philosophy is there. And this is all in Gita. There are many more. But in Brahma Sutra, again he says, Doidino hite sanghyaha yogascha. You see, this Sankhya philosophy and Yoga philosophy, they are dualistic philosophies. Okay. Na atme ekatva darshinaha. They are not saying about non-dual self. So they are establishing the duality. Na atme ekatva darshinaha. They don't know about oneness of consciousness. Yena tu amshena na viruddhyade tena ishtameva sankhya yoga smrityor savakashatva. So what is not contradicting with our philosophy, we are accepting that. Na viruddhyade yena tu amshena na viruddhyade. The what part of that philosophy is not contradicting with our philosophy, we are taking that. We are accepting that. We are not against any philosophy. Savakashattvam. Which is the part, what part you take? So he is quoting that. Asango hyayam purushaha. So this Sankhya also says, Yoga also says, the purusha is indifferent from all the manifestation. The consciousness is completely detached from the creation. It is just observer. So this part, this philosophy, they accept it. So we also accept it because this is in this is there in Brihadaranyaka Upanishad. So it is an Upanishad philosophy. So we accepted that part. So this is the connection. You can see many more things are there. Now, only this part is different. What part? The duality of Sankhya is different. But if you see the sadhana part, even Shankaracharya himself says, if you want to know about more about meditation techniques, so you study Yoga Darsana, that is what he says. And in Shankara Bhashya, you can see some wordings of Vyasa Bhashya. So some examples. So it means he must have studied Vyasa Bhashya also. Some wordings are there, same examples, because only you can find those wordings in Vyasa Bhashya. Because this is one of the oldest Bhashyas, one of the oldest commentaries. This Vyasa Bhashya we have. That is the language also is very tough. Even in it is in Sanskrit, but it is old Sanskrit. The words he used. So see, this is the similarity and dissimilarities. So main dissimilarity is that is dualistic and this is non-dualistic. And now Vedanta says how Vedanta brings creation. It is very interesting because Vedanta is taking all the benefit from all the darshanas. Whatever they established which is useful, Vedanta takes all that. That is why when we study Vedanta, Vedanta seems to be perfect philosophically, and the methodology and everything is perfect because it took from everywhere. It's based on Vedantic Upanishad philosophy. Now, how this all-pervading Brahman, which is pure existence, pure consciousness, and bliss, Satchitananda. This is the nature of Brahman, Swarupa Lakshana. And this Brahman is attributionless. There is no attributions. Then how can it produce the outside world? How can it produce something? Because without material cause, it cannot produce. Knowledge cannot produce anything if there is no material cause. You know how to prepare dosa or idli. You know you are well versed in that. But without the material, what we call atta, without that you cannot make. You need that paste to make. So, okay, Brahman is pure consciousness. Brahman knows everything, but how can Brahma produce this world? It's a problem. So there, we in Vedanta philosophy, we attribute Maya into Brahman. This is, this is a philosophical terminology. Ishvara is not Ishvara, it's a defined Ishvara. It means you have to know. You must know what is the definition of Ishvara. Otherwise, you will not know what is Ishvara is. Because here the Ishvara is different. This is defined Ishvara as a yogic Ishvara. And there we have Ishvara. The same word is used there. But is that Vedantic Ishvara. So it's Vedantic Ishvara is different from yogic Ishvara. Because terminology is it's a technical term in Vedanta. Now, there we make the consciousness as a material cause and efficient cause, both. And how it become material cause, we add Maya there. the pure consciousness with attributed Maya is called Ishvara. So Maya is attributed, philosophically attributed for the purpose. So now with Maya, this consciousness can create. You see, here these Sankhyas, they are Sankhya philosophers, the new Sankhya philosophers, they are just taking this point. You see, without this material cause, you cannot create. Then why you won't accept our Prakriti there? Why you are saying that Prakriti is different, Prakriti is, your philosophy is dualistic and all those things? We are saying the same thing. You are taking the Prakriti as Maya and connecting with the Ishvara. We are just separating it and directly we are taking it as a source of creation. The same. And what is the nature of Maya? The quality, the characteristic of Maya is same as Prakriti, Trigunatmika. It stays there. Only difference, these Trigunas cannot be activated without the permission of consciousness. It means consciousness is activating the Maya. Consciousness is the substratum of creation. The Sankhya, consciousness is not the substratum of creation. Prakriti is the substratum of creation. This is the difference. So we are bringing that Trigunas into consciousness. So again, the Trigunas also a manifestation of consciousness. And this everything happened because of Ajnana. Because these attributed qualities are just attributed there. After you know this, there is no Maya, there is no Ishvara, only pure consciousness remains. That is the Vedanta. We say this methodology, this theory as Adhyaropa Apavada. Adhyaropa Apavada theory. This is attribute negating theory, attribution negation theory. So first we attribute, then we establish the philosophy, then negate it. So after negation, nedi, this is not true. The after negation, only the consciousness remains. So this is the speciality in this contest regarding Vedanta. Now, for Vedanta, whatever you see is a manifestation of reflection of consciousness. That is also true. Because what we see as energy, what we see as material cause, is everything based on consciousness. So this is a manifestation of that. And that is the first the creator, as the creator. Then from that, the first creation is Hiranyagarbha, the cosmic intelligence. If you compare with the Sankhya, here it is Mahat. So that Hiranyagarbha, we call it Hiranyagarbha, that is cosmic intelligence with cosmic energy, all the energies. Because the Prana Shakti is also there, Kriya Shakti is also there, everything is there. That is Hiranyagarbha. From that, Virat comes. Virat means, again, the gross, cosmic gross body. The gross elements in cosmic level is called Virat. Virato Ajayata. So from that, the five elements, then the creation. This is the theory we can see in Vedanta. So all the five elements, and then they have this panjikarana, dividing into five and distributing all these things, and then the creation is there. So that is okay, that is only the gross form of that. But the main difference is there. the Maya and Prakriti. We see this together as synonymous in Gita. In Bhagavan uses Maya, Prakriti interchanging for the same concept. So, Mama Maya Durathyaya. That is my Maya. And I am controlling the Maya. That is Mama Shakti, is my power. So I control. So Tasmin Garbham Dadamyaham. I create through Maya. So this is what Bhagavan says. So these are the, you can say, some points of comparison. So we conclude with this here. By the blessings of all our masters, we could study Patanjali Yoga Darshana, and now practice and attaining the benefits of that. That is up to us. Now you take as your life. I told you this yogic life. Yoga is not only a practice. This should be life. So we discussed this when we were discussing about Yama Niyamas, starting from the morning shower, from there the yogic life starts until you sleep. So try to apply one by one, so then you can see the changes. So we pray to Almighty that we get the blessings and support from all the masters of yoga and our own masters. So they bless us. Om Purnamataha Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudasyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vasishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti.